If you're a male suffering from erectile dysfunction, one potential course of treatment could be getting a penile implant. Penile implants, or prostheses, are devices that are surgically placed inside the penis to allow men with erectile dysfunction to get an erection during sexual intercourse. Penile implants can be used to treat Peyronie's disease, which is a severe condition that causes scarring inside the penis, leading to curved, painful erections. However, it's important to note that this procedure is usually a last resort. Most men with erectile dysfunction are able to treat the condition with medication or by using a penis pump. Now, if you've tried these methods and they've been unsuccessful, or you're not a candidate for these treatments, then you should consult your doctor, who will be able to do a complete examination and determine whether or not a penile implant could be right for you, in consultation with a specialist doctor called a urologist. If you're suffering from an infection or you've got uncontrolled diabetes, you might not be eligible for this surgery. Now, there are two main types of penile implants. The first is inflatable implants, which can be inflated to create an erection and then deflated after sexual activity. Inflatable implants come in two varieties, a two-piece as well as a three-piece implant. Now, with a three-piece implant, salt water is stored in a reservoir that is implanted under the abdominal wall. The water is then manually pumped into inflatable cylinders that are inside the penis. After intercourse, the penis is then deflated by the water exiting back into the reservoir through a release valve that is implanted in the scrotum, which is the sac of skin that is surrounding your testicles. Now, on the other hand, the two-piece implant differs in that the reservoir is part of the pump that's implanted into the scrotum rather than in the abdominal wall. Now, the second type of penile implant are semi-rigid rods, which always keep the penis firm. Now, with this type of implant, the penis can be bent away from the body during sexual activity and toward the body at other times. Now, there are risks and benefits for each type of implant. For example, a three-piece inflatable implant provides the most natural erection. However, the device has got more parts, and therefore there's a greater risk of potential malfunction. A two-piece implant is less likely to malfunction, but provides a less firm erection. Lastly, the semi-rigid rods that we talked about are easier to use, but since the penis is always firm, it can be harder to conceal it, and the pressure on the penis can lead to injury. Now, it's important to discuss the different types of implants with your doctor to determine which one is right for you. Now, in terms of what to expect during the operation, the surgery will start off with a catheter, which is a rubber tube to help pass urine, being inserted through the penis into your bladder. The incision is usually made at the junction of the penis and the scrotum, again, which is the sac of skin holding your testicles. A second incision might be used to insert the balloon reservoir, which is part of the inflatable implant, into the abdomen if you're having a three-piece inflatable implant. Next, the surgeon will stretch the spongy tissue in the penis that would normally fill with blood during an erection. The surgeon will then place the correct size implant inside your penis. Now, this procedure usually lasts between 45 minutes to an hour. If an inflatable implant has been used, it might be left in the inflated position overnight to reduce the risk of bleeding, but it will then be deflated before you're discharged home. Now, here in the UK, the average time spent in the hospital after this surgery is around a day. The catheter will usually be removed on the morning following the surgery. Once you're passing urine normally, you'll be able to go home. Now, you might feel some pain at the incision site after surgery. Remember, this is an operation, so this is only normal. But over-the-counter pain relief like paracetamol and ibuprofen should be sufficient to help you manage the pain. After surgery, you're advised not to inflate the implant or to have sexual intercourse for at least 6 weeks. You'll also be requested to come back to the clinic to learn how to inflate and deflate the implant properly. Now, whilst negative side effects after this operation are rare, there are risks, and these can include temporary bruising or swelling of the penis that might last several days, nerve injury, which may lead to numbness of the head of the penis, malfunctioning of the implant that might require surgical removal, internal erosion or adhesion of the implant, whereby the implant might stick to the skin or wear away from the skin, as well as infections, which might require the removal of the implant. Now, infections are most common in the first 3 months after surgery. Now, for all of these potential risks and complications, it's best to discuss them with the surgeon who is going to be carrying out your procedure. It's also important to weigh out the risks and benefits of this procedure and again discuss these with your doctor to make sure that you're making an informed decision before choosing this procedure, because like anything, it comes with pros as well as cons. I've included lots of links in the description box of this video which contain more useful information about this procedure from trusted sources, but I hope you found this introductory video useful, helpful, as well as informative. Now, if you do have any questions, please do leave them in the comments section. I'll do my best to reply, and until next time, thanks for watching and bye.